Hello, we are with Maya Horowitz from Checkpoint during the Checkpoint Experience Spain. Hello, Maya.
Hello.
Maya, how can we deal with a threat when the enemy is a nation state?
So actually today, attacks done by nation states are not that different from other attacks that we see, like cyber crime, because actually nation states also take tools that are available out there and reuse them in their own code. Sometimes they even hire hackers to do the attacks for them. We've seen a few such cases in the past. So eventually even nation states, they would just use any vulnerability, any malware, any Trojan that we see out there, and they're not necessarily more sophisticated than anything else.
Crypto mining and ransomware fight to be first on the list of threats. Which do you think is more dangerous?
So actually, the crypto miners are by far leading the charts. So today, every week, about 30% of the organizations are being targeted by one type of crypto miner or another. While with ransomware, the numbers are much, much lower. So if you talk about the numbers, there are so many more attacks with crypto miners. And if you talk about the damage, then it varies, because with some crypto miners, the financial damage is huge. For example, especially if the crypto miner is being installed on cloud infrastructure, then they can use the feature of auto-scaling of clouds, meaning that if they want more resources, more computation resources, the cloud infrastructure would give it to them. So at the end of the month, the organization would see it in the paycheck for the cloud infrastructure. So financially, it can be huge. While with ransomware, actually with some types of ransomware, you can decrypt the files without paying the ransom, because they're not that sophisticated and there are free decryption tools that are published. But of course, it can still be a pretty big ransom to pay. But it can be prevented quite easily, especially if you take the time to do backups of the network and the data. Then you can just revert the network when something like that happened instead of paying the ransom. With crypto miners, they can just stay in the background for months without you noticing and just do the damage behind the scenes.
How important is threat intelligence for a cybersecurity strategy?
So threat intelligence is hugely important, not only because that's what I do, but also because it's not enough to have security products. It's also very important to be aware of the cyber attacks and the types of cyber attacks for two reasons. One is to educate the company, the organization, the people, because we are sometimes the weakest link. I mean, if we get an email and it seems interesting, we get we just want to double click the attachment, and we just let the malware in the network. So this is why the data, the intelligence is important in education, but it's also important to the product, because you need to know what you defend against, and the products, the security products, need to be up to date and to have all the intelligence and knowledge that the threat actors have. So a threat actor can look for a vulnerability or a malware in the internet and in dark forums, and we have to have this information so that we can protect against such potential attacks before the threat actors have the chance to actually use it.
And the last, Maya, do we need another WannaCry for companies to start doing something around security?
So, you know, WannaCry was huge. It was about 200,000 infections in just 3 days. And it was, you know, global chaos. But still, you'd be surprised to hear that people forget about it really fast. So it's not like the day after WannaCry, thousands of organizations were running to upgrade their security posture. So I don't really believe in these one-time huge mega attacks in order to convince people that they need to have better security. I think that it's, you know, one day at a time. And this is why it's very important for me and for us as Check Point to always publish the new things that we see so that people can see that the cyber attacks are not just these huge attacks, but also what happens in between, which is the daily operation of the threat actors that we need to defend against.
Thank you so much, Maya.
Thank you very much. It was a pleasure.